wasted effort. Portions of Zechariah chapter 7 from verse 1 to 6. And it came to pass in the fourth year of King Darius that the word of the Lord came unto Zechariah, when they had sent unto the house of God Sherezer and Regemelech to speak unto the prophet, saying, Should I weep in the fifth month, separating myself, as I have done these so many years? Then came the word of the Lord of hosts unto me, saying, Speak unto all the people of the land, and to the priests, saying, When you fasted and mourned in the fifth and seventh month, even those 70 years, did ye at all fast unto me, even to me? And when ye did eat, and when ye did drink, did you not eat for yourselves and drink for yourselves? We are approaching the beginning of yet another year. Many believers are fasting and praying that God should reveal what he expects of them in the coming year regarding the work of the ministry, their Christian life, and other areas. The answer the Lord will give to many is similar to what he sent through Zechariah to his people in the passage read earlier. He will ask if they have really lived and worked for him in the outgoing year to deserve him telling them what to do in the coming one. Unfortunately, many believers will not hear the real answer that the Lord is giving to their inquiry. Some ask him questions but are not patient enough to wait and hear what he has to say, or they allow their hearts to give them answers which they turn around to attribute to the Holy Spirit. Note though that it is possible for a believer to make an honest error in thinking that the Holy Spirit of God said a particular thing to him when he actually did not. So there are times when the Lord may be trying to point out a believer's error, but because he does not pay enough attention, he believes that God has spoken one thing to him. Meanwhile, what God said is completely different from what he heard. Just like it happened in the case of the people who thought that they were mourning, weeping, and fasting unto God for 70 years. Meanwhile, as far as God was concerned, what they were doing was not unto him, but unto themselves. So it is today with many Christians. Year in, year out, they go through the rituals of Christianity, doing what they think should make the Lord happy. However, if only they would listen attentively, they would hear the Lord saying that most, if not all, of the things they've been doing are for themselves and not for him. Thus, many Christians have been making wasted efforts. One of the things that can make a believer's efforts in Christ be wasted is failing to ask him for instruction and direction. God is the only one that knows how we can please him. So the believer who does not depend on him for direction will end up doing things his or her own way, which will never be pleasing to the Lord. Another thing is that some believers ask for and receive directions from God but fail to follow them. This may be due to stubbornness, thinking that one has a better way of handling things than the way that the Lord suggested, looking at and following the instruction that God gave to someone else, and so on. Following God's instruction with wrong motives is another thing that can result in wasted effort. Some believers do things to glorify themselves instead of God, and since he wants to be the one glorified in all things, he has not respect for their efforts. The motive of some is to prove themselves to be better than everyone else, while some do things because they are envious of someone else and want to show that they also have the ability to do what that person is doing. Note that it is possible to start out with the right motive and then switch unconsciously along the line. This brings us again to the importance of not just guarding our hearts with all diligence, but also submitting often to the Holy Spirit for checkup. That way we can nip in the bud any negative feeling or motive that wants to creep in and ruin our relationship with and service to the Lord. Also, following God's instruction and direction but with sin, wickedness, oppression, and so on will render a believer's efforts worthless before the Lord. Have you really lived and worked for God this year? Ask him and listen to what he has to say. If he convinces you that you did not, there is still hope for you to do the right thing in the coming year. The key to ensuring that our efforts in the coming year will not be wasted is to do what the Lord pointed out to his people in Zechariah chapter 7 verse 7a. Should ye not hear the words which the Lord hath cried? Let us learn to listen and hear from the Lord. We should also learn to trust his wisdom and knowledge even when what he is telling us does not seem to make sense. There are times, for instance, when all that the Lord wants a believer to do is just sit still. At such times, if that believer chooses to get busy and run from one corner to the other because there is much to be done and he thinks he cannot afford to sit still, he is not running for God but for himself, and the effort he is making is a waste. Decide that your efforts in the coming year will not be wasted. May the Lord give us wisdom in Jesus' name. Amen.